To explore loops further, we'll get some hands-on experience creating and running loops and Visual Studio Code in this video. Inside my terminal, once I'm in my Rust projects directory, I will type cargo new loops. Then let's go ahead and change directories to the loops package and open that up. So let's start with an example of a loop with a break. I'm going to define a mutable variable called I, which is going to be equal to 1. And then I want to define a new variable called something, which is going to be equal to this loop. And what we're going to do in this loop is constantly increment the value of I. So we're going to have I times 2 is going to be equal to I. And then I want to say if I is greater than 100, then I want to go ahead and break I. So it's going to break out of that loop when I is anything greater than 100. And then I'm going to go ahead and close out this loop, and then I can add an assertion. So an assertion here, I might just want to look at the value and what I expect the value to be after a certain time. So I'm going to use the assert equal macro and say that something will eventually be equal to 128. So what's happening in this loop, we can just take a closer look, is that I is going to be equal to 1. It's going to come into this loop. I times 2 is going to be equal to 2. So if I is less than 100, will we break out of this? No. So then we come around the loop again. So 2 times I is going to be equal to I, so that's going to be 4. And then we're going to continue through this loop until we have a value greater than 100. And at that point, the value is going to actually be equal to 128. So you can run that and assert that this actually is correct. Next, let's go ahead and explore a while loop. So here I want to have let mute counter is equal to 0. And then I can say while counter is less than 10, I want to print out the value hello. And then what I want to do is increment the value of my counter. So counter is going to be equal to counter plus 1. And so we're going to keep going through this loop with the counter starting at 0. Within the first while loop, the counter is going to be equal to 1. And then we're going to do this all the way until the value of counter is 9, which is less than 10. And the last time when it gets incremented, we will not be able to go through that loop again. So then the program can continue executing. And for our last demonstration, I want to show another example of a for loop. So let's go ahead and look at an example of creating an iterator with a for loop using the range notation. So for this, I want to say for each item in the range of 0 to 5. So I can annotate that just by using those two dots. And then I want to go ahead and add a print statement. And within this print statement, I want to go ahead and print out each item times 2. In this example, the code iterates through the numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4 and binds them to the item variable. For each iteration, the value printed will be item times 2. So first, when the number is bound to the item variable for 0, it's going to be 0 times 2, which is equal to 0. Then for 1, it'll be 1 times 2, which is equal to 2, and so on until the upper range of 4 is reached. So I hope that these examples of seeing loop, while, and for help to build your understanding of how to use loops. There are still lots of different scenarios that we didn't cover here, so feel free to explore this program more, adding in your own examples, running, and just seeing what else you can learn about loops.